whole family to America. And I chose Arizona because it's quiet. I have a good friend there. And Arizona air is Mormon. For Mormon, even drink coffee or tea is a sin. So I have four daughters. Okay? So I'm worried. So I better find a safe place to raise up my children. So I was there. I moved over with them also. So if I have nothing to do, then it's going to be a boring life. Nothing to do in America. So I'm thinking, what can I do? I cannot sell hamburger to compete with McDonald's. I cannot sell Kentucky Fried Chicken with KFC. So one thing I think I can do better is open a Muay Thai camp that in America. They don't have any Muay Thai camp yet. And they don't know much about Muay Thai. So I think, well, this is a good idea. And on the same time, for those fighter who is retired, become my bodyguard or my driver, and I find out that if they can easily accept by immigration because they have special skill, they are trained Muay Thai trainer, so we can bring them over. So when I can bring them over, they can bring their wife. So their wife is also is our maid in our house. So it worked out perfectly. So I decided to open a Muay Thai camp. I can bring my trainer. They're going to be my bodyguard in America. They're going to be my driver in America. Their wife going to help me in America. So I bring four trainer down, and they bring their wife down to America. So we start that. For those 4 years, you know, because we are talking 25 years ago, still don't people doesn't know much about Muay Thai. So I'm losing money every month, but like I say, it's very luckily other business I'm making money, so I don't mind to lose some money over there. But when I come back, I think if I bring everyone back, if I stop, so for those 4 years, investment and time is going to waste. So I want to keep my root there. Even we are not making money, but we are doing quite okay, and people start know what is Muay Thai, people start want to learn Muay Thai. So I talked with one of our customers in San Francisco and asked him to help me to run. I give him all my trainer, I help him to give him my ring, give him everything, and even financially I support him, okay? Just want my root, you know, to stay in America. So I mean, his name is called Alex Kong. So unfortunately, after he helped me for a few years, he was killed in one incident, and then you know, my son-in-law take over. My son-in-law take over, and do the Fairtex camp in America continue. As for me, I came back.